Welcome back, students. Today we will study the economic zoology. Here we have to study the life cycle and economic importance of three insects. Number one, silkworm. Number two, honeybee. Number three, lag insect. Let's first study silkworm. The process of obtaining silk from silkworms on commercial scale is called sericulture. The various species of silkworms are: number one, Bombax mori, that is mulberry silk. Number two, Anthria osama, moga silkworm. Number three, Ataxus ricini, iri silkworm. Number four, Ataxus otus, giant silkworm. Let us have a look on the life cycle of silkworm. Silkworm is dioecious, that is, sexes are separate. Fertilization internal. Development is complete by metamorphosis. Now we will study the life cycle of silkworm. This can be studied under following headings. Number one, copulation and egg laying. The adult female moth is larger than male and has feeble wings, so it cannot fly. After copulation, female lays 300 to 500 eggs on mulberry leaves. To avoid falling off eggs, they are covered by gelatinous material which causes them to stick surface leaves. Eggs are white and size of pinhead. If conditions are favorable, that is, there is optimum temperature to 37 degrees Celsius and enough humidity in atmosphere, eggs hatch within 12 days into larvae called caterpillars. Number two, caterpillars. Caterpillar is the larva of silkworm. At the time of hatching, caterpillar is very small, has mandibulate mouthparts with which it at once starts feeding on mulberry leaves and grows very quickly. After 4 to 5 days, it stops feeding and becomes inactive, after which molting takes place. The earlier silk bursts and it starts eating, molts again. This process is repeated 4 times. The period between successive molts is called an instar. Remember this point, instar. It is always oscured in entrance. The fully grown caterpillar measures 7.5 cm in length. Its body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Head bears mouth with mandibulate mouthparts, that is, biting and chewing type. Thorax bears 3 pairs of segmented true legs. Abdomen has 10 segments. The last segment has a dorsal horn. Abdomen bears 5 pairs of pseudo legs in the form of stumps. Thorax as well as abdominal bear lateral spiracles connected to trachea for respiration. Caterpillar feeds on mulberry leaves and develops salivary glands, after which it stops feeding. Remember one thing here, silk is produced in salivary glands of the caterpillar. Number third, pupa and cocoon. Caterpillar releases saliva from salivary glands through a fine pore called spinneret present on hypopharynx. As soon as this saliva comes in contact with air, it solidifies and forms silk fibers. During this process, it moves its head left and right so that its body is covered by concentric layers of silk fibers, forming a silk shell called cocoon. Caterpillar remains dormant in the cocoon and is called pupa. Formation of cocoon occurs in diffused light. Pupa undergoes metamorphosis in cocoon. During metamorphosis, abdomen becomes short and abdominal pouch, abdominal pseudo legs disappear. Wings appear on the thorax and caterpillar changes into young moth called as amago. Amago secretes an alkaline secretion to moisten walls of cocoon and cut it into form of pore. amoeba escapes through this spore and develops into an adult moth. Let us study the economic importance of silk. Silk is called the queen of textiles because silk fiber never creates any reaction on the skin and can be used in all seasons. Number two, silk thread is used in making ropes. Number three, silk is used in making parachutes. Number four, silk thread is used in making nets for catching fish. Let us study composition of silk. Silk is composed of two kinds of amorphic colloidal proteins. Number one, fibrin, 75%. Number two, sericin, 25%. Let us study the disease of silkworms. Number one, fibrin or paper disease by protozoan Nosema. Number two, muscaridine fungal disease. Thank you very much.